Welcome to all students in properties and selection of sliding contact bearing. It is a very important topic. This is a diagram of sliding contact bearings where oil inlet, housing, bearing liner clearance, split type and journal of shaft is shown. This is a fixed element and this is a moving element. Now we discuss about advantages and disadvantages. Plain bearings are cheap to produce and have noiseless operation. They can be easily machined, occupy small radial space and have vibration damping properties. Also, they can cope with tap foreign matter. Disadvantages are they require large supply of lubricating oil. They are suitable only for relative low temperature and speed, and starting resistance is much greater than the running resistance due to slow buildup of lubricant film around the bearing surface. In material properties, these are the material properties like compressive strength, fatigue strength, comparability, that is ability of bearing material to accommodate sharp deflections and bearing inaccuracies by plastic deformation without excessive wear and heating. Its imbedability is the ability of bearing material to accommodate or embed small particles of dust, grit without scoring the material of the journal. In bondability, many high capacity bearings are made up of bonding one or more thin layers of a bearing material to a high strength steel shell. Thus, the strength of the bond, that is bondability, is an important consideration in selecting bearing material. In material properties, they are corrosion resistance, thermal conductivity, thermal expansion. But the bearing material should be of low coefficient of thermal expansion so that when the bearing operates over a wide range of temperature, there is no underchange in the clearance. In material properties, these are the material properties, very important table, like fatigue strength. First, bearing material, fatigue strength, comparability, embeddability, anti-scoring, corrosion resistance and thermal conductivity. These are the properties of metallic bearing materials. This is a different material like tin-based babbitt, lead-based babbitt, lead, bronze, copper lead, aluminum and silver. In materials commonly used is babbitt material. The tin-based and lead-based babbitts are widely used as a bearing material because they satisfy most requirements of general applications. The babbitts are recommended where the maximum bearing pressure on projected area is not over 7 to 14 Newton per mm square. When applied in automobiles, the babbitt is generally used as a thin layer 0.05 mm to 0.15 mm thick, bonded through an insert or steel shell. The composition of the babbitt material is as follows. Tin-based babbitts like tin 90%, copper 4.5%, antimony 5%, lead 0.5%, lead-based babbitts are lead 84%, tin 6%, antimony 9.5%, copper 0.5%. Materials commonly used, that is bronzes. The bronzes, bracket alloy of copper, tin and zinc, are generally used in the form of machine bushes pressed into the shell. The bush may be in one or two pieces. The bronze commonly used for bearing material are gun metal and phosphor bronzes. The gun metal, in bracket copper 88%, tin 10%, zinc 2%, is used for high grade bearing subjected to high pressures not more than 10 Newton per mm square of projected area and high speeds. The phosphorus bronze. Also, cast iron is used, silver is used. Also, in non-metallic bearings, the various non-metallic bearings are made of carbon, graphite, rubber, wood and plastics. The carbon graphite bearings are self-lubricating, dimensionally stable over a wide range of operating conditions, chemically inert and can operate at higher temperatures than other bearings. Such type of bearings are used in food processing and other equipment where contamination by oil or grease must be prohibited. The soft rubber bearings are used with water or other low viscosity lubricants, particularly where sand or other large particles are present. In addition to the high degree of embeddability and comfortability, the rubber bearings are excellent for absorbing shock, loads and vibration. The wood bearings are used in many applications where low cost, cleanliness, intention to lubrication and anti-seizing are important. This is a non-metallic bearing. This is a material commonly used. So now we discuss about lubrication on journal bearing. There is thick film bearings. The thick film bearings are those in which the working surfaces are completely separated from each other by the lubricant. Such type of bearings are also called as hydrodynamic lubricated bearings. In thin film bearings, the thin film bearings are those in which, although lubricant is present, the working surfaces partially contact each other at least part of the time. Such type of bearings are also called boundary lubricated bearings. Next is zero film bearings. The zero film bearings are those which operate without any lubricant present. Also, in four number, hydrostatic or externally pressurized lubricated bearings. The hydrostatic bearings are those which can support steady loads without any relative motion between the journal and the bearing. This is achieved by forcing externally pressurized lubricant between the members. Okay, this is the hydrodynamic bearing. It is lubricated journal bearing that uses fluid, liquid or gas lubricants to separate the moving surfaces completely without an external pressure supply. Required pressure to support journal inside the bearing is generated from wedging action inside the journal. This is the load static, this is the load startup, load running. In hydrodynamic bearing, load is transferred through a lubricant in sliding contact bearing. This is the shaft, this is the slew bearing. Shaft stationary metal contacts, shaft rotating slowly boundary hydrostatic bearings. In hydrostatic bearing, this is the figure, shaft bearing oil inlet pump. When load runner bearing raises restricted and film thickness. Now we discuss about. It is also known as externally pressurized lubrication, in which the pressurized lubricant pump into clearance of bearing and the journal, hence it can support higher loads even at stationary condition with very low starting friction resulting very low tear and wear, but they are very expensive. So thanks all of you.